Hey kid, come here. Hey kid, come here. Come here. What day is it?
It's Friday.
What do we do on Friday?
Watch the Friday show.
It's completely idiotic.
There's always that one person that will always have your heart.
Alright, what's your name and who am I here with?
I'm Rylan Guppy.
What up, Rylan? Do you have a Valentine this year?
I do.
You do? And did they ask you to be their Valentine or did you ask them?
I kind of both, I guess.
Kind of both? Alright, you got any plans tonight?
I do not.
No?
Not tonight, this weekend, no problem.
This weekend? Alright, well, my last question. What's your favorite thing about your Valentine?
Her hair.
Her hair? That's what's up, man. Respectfully.
Yes, sir.
I'm here with Gus. Hey Gus, you got a Valentine?
Yeah.
Who is it?
Cammy.
Cammy?
Yeah.
How long have you guys been together?
Since I was 5.
Do you love her?
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing about her?
Everything.
Everything?
Yeah.
What's your least favorite thing about her?
Nothing.
Nothing? If she asked to marry you right now, what would you say?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm here with Gavin Sorensen. Hey Gavin, do you have a Valentine?
I do. I have my girlfriend, Tori Nation.
Awesome. You guys been together for a while?
Oh yeah, over 2 years now.
Congrats, man. So did you ask her? Did she ask you?
I asked her.
You asked her? Mm-hmm. You gotta get her some flowers?
I mean, I'm taking her out to dinner for sure.
Out to dinner? Take me out to dinner. Do you love her?
Of course I do.
Keep the love like that, Wildcats. I'm here with Henry Moss and Lainey Wolf. Hey guys, so it's Valentine's Day. You got any big plans tonight?
No.
Not really.
Practice.
Practice?
Yeah.
You guys get each other any gifts?
Nope.
You'd get a sucker.
Oh. You got a sucker?
Heart-shaped sucker.
What's your least favorite thing about your Valentine's Day this year?
I mean, she's always making fun of my sleeveless shirts I wear on Flex Friday.
What's your least favorite thing about it?
Daddy, where is that shirt on Flex Friday?
Alright, now give each other a hug, just to make sure you guys still like each other. Thanks, guys.
I'm here with Margaret Burkhart. Hey, do you have a Valentine? You do? Did they ask you to be the Valentine? They did? What are your plans today on this Valentine's Day?
We're going to Chicago because I
have okay. Well, congrats on the Valentine. One last question. What's your least favorite thing about them? There's nothing wrong with that.
I'm here with
Mrs. Moore,
Mrs. Spratt,
Mr. Glass,
Ms. Black,
Mr. Robinson,
Ms. Story,
Mrs. Hill,
Ms. Fontana,
Mrs. McClusick.
Ms. Moore, you live in a one-story house. Everything in the house is pink. What color are the stairs?
Pink.
Lime green.
Red.
White.
Oh.
There's no stairs because it's a one-story house.
Oh.
It's a one-story house. There's no stairs. It's a one-story house. There are no stairs.
Oh, God.
It's a one-story house. There are no stairs.
What if there's a basement?
Basements don't count.
Okay.
But God, I wanna feel again.
I am here with
Mrs. Mulder.
Mrs. Rolandini.
Mrs. Egler.
I think you know my name by now.
I'm in a one-story house. There are no stairs.
I live in a one-story house. It's a one-story house.
I thought you said the house was one-story.
What up, Wildcats? Today I'm going to go around asking Wayland High School students some fake Super Bowl trivia.
I'm here with Garrett Sport. Garrett. Did you watch the Super Bowl?
Yes, I did.
How'd you feel about rookie Eagles receiver John Carter III breaking the all-time Super Bowl record for receiving yards? Pretty impressive for a rookie, right?
Yeah.
Do you think that kid has a bright future?
He possibly could. I mean, possibility.
Appreciate it.
You watched Super Bowl?
Oh, yes, sir, I did.
The cap.
How do you feel about the Chiefs receiver, Aubrey Graham, scoring 2 touchdowns for the Super Bowl?
He looked amazing, so yeah, it must be the MVP of the Super Bowl.
Yeah. Harris, did you watch Super Bowl?
Yeah, I did watch the Super Bowl.
All right, how do you feel about Eagles middle linebacker, Giancarlo Esposito, getting 5 TFLs, tying the Super Bowl record?
Pretty solid.
Do you think he's a second-year player? Do you think he's just going to keep getting better?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You watch Super Bowl?
Yeah.
How do you feel about Eagles DN Brian Cranston getting 4 sacks, tying his bowl record?
Kansas City.
What did he say?
Kansas Chief won.
Well, how do you feel about him breaking or tying the record there?
I don't really care.
It just doesn't matter because the Chiefs won?
Wow.
People will really believe whatever you tell them. Thanks for watching and tune in next week for an even better feature.
Alright, so for this week's feature, we'll be asking a couple people like if they can win in a race, and we'll see who can win. Alright, here with Gary and Rob. And who do you guys think would win in a race?
Garrett.
Alright, let's see it. All right, I'm here with Goody and Cam, and who do you guys think is going to win the race?
Oh, I got this 100%.
Goody?
I'm not slow, so I think I got him.
All right, we got Cam.
Oh, Goody! No!
All right, I'm here with Drew and Alex, and who do you guys think will win the race?
Well, I have a bad knee. He's winning.
So he has an excuse.
I also have bad knees and I'm slow.
Both have bad knees.
But I'm still going to win.
All right. Let's see it.
It was my shot. Paris.
All right, I'm here with Anya in Brooklyn. Who do you guys think will win the race?
Me, of course. I mean, I haven't ran in a while. But...
Okay, but who actually do you think will win? All right, that's it. Thanks, Juan.
Hi guys, we're going to be finding the students that have made it to state for solo and ensemble, for choir solo and ensemble, and we're going to be asking them questions about the performance. One of the questions we are going to ask is what score that they got. So I'm going to explain what the scores mean really quick. It's out of 30, and the higher the score, the better. But then it gets tiered into 1 through 5, 1 being the best. So who are you?
I'm Andy Hines.
Nicolette Harrison.
Caden Balch.
So we have a couple questions about solo and ensemble.
Okay.
So first question, what songs did you perform?
I performed Danny Boy and Walker's Eyes.
I performed Jesus Walked This Lonesome Valley and Christopher Robin Is Saying His Prayers.
Okay.
Requiem and Come Let's Be Merry.
Okay. What notes were you given on those songs that for points you could improve on?
My breathing technique needed improvement, so.
Alright.
A lot about breath support and musical ones. Mm-hmm.
I have to stop directing myself and apparently I was doing too much.
Okay. What were your songs about?
Love Has Eyes is about, you know, in love, you gotta be able to see what the other person's doing all the time and act on it. Danny Boy, as everybody knows, is just a sad song about death.
Jesus. Both of them.
Lovely.
Yeah.
What are your songs about?
Death and a person being happy.
Okay. Did you agree with the score that you got?
No. I think breathing should have been a 4 and not a 3.
What score did you get overall?
A 27.
Pretty good score though.
Yeah.
A 1. I got a 24 out of 30.
Cool. Do you agree with your score?
I think I should have gotten a high 2, but that's okay.
Cool.
A 5. I think it was a 25.
So that could be a 1?
Yes.
A 1?
Yes.
Alright. Do you agree with your score?
Yeah, I could have done better.
Alright. Thank you. Thank you guys for watching. We're all very proud of our choir students for making it to State Solon Ensemble.
Hey Waylon, we're having Elijah and Dustin ask teachers what they are doing for their futures at the end of the school year.
I'm here with Coach Gibson, and Coach, what is your futures for the end of the year?
I am with Ms. Cardosa, and we are taking a group out to Yankee Springs for golf on Monday, and then games back here on day two.
Boom, there you go.
All right, I'm with Coach Wes Hudson. What future are you doing?
We're doing wiffle ball tournament.
And so pretty simple, just playing wiffle ball. I won the championship last year.
You did win. You were part of that winning team last year. That is true.
That team is pretty good.
Not bad.
I'm here with Coach Harder, and I'm going to ask him what his future is for the end of the year.
We go kayaking. We do one day on Gun Lake. That day we do a cookout. Nice and calm. Second day we actually go down the river. A little bit more challenging. Have to pack your own lunch, but it's a lot of fun.
Here you go. Go enjoy it.
I'm with Ms. Denhoff, and you're just going to tell me what future you're doing.
Shop to drop. We will be going day one to Tanger Outlets and day two to Woodland Mall.
Spend that bag.